good betrayal always catches you off guard. When we're playing a video game, we're usually in some kind of strange world that we're not very familiar with, so we rely on the in-game characters to keep us on the right track, to steer us in the right direction. But when those characters decide to screw you over, it completely turns everything on its head and makes us question the entire narrative. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we're going to be taking a look at and counting down 10 of the most shocking video game betrayals ever. And I want you guys in the comment section to let me know the one that shocked you the most. And of course, there are going to be plenty of spoilers ahead, so spoiler alert. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Kicking off our list at number 10 is Dimitri in Grand Theft Auto 4. Now, this is one of my personal favorites in the GTA series. I love Grand Theft Auto 4. It launched in 2008, and the story follows Nico, a veteran who returns home and attempts to find a man who betrayed his squad during battle, but ends up getting dragged into the world of organized crime in Liberty City. Now, Dimitri helps you out during the game, giving you missions for the money, but he ends up turning on you in a pretty big way. After burning your house down, he proceeds to send men after you to kill you, resulting in him destroying your life entirely and becoming the main villain of the game. Now, you may have seen this one coming, given the fact that Dimitri is a criminal, and this turn doesn't seem too out of character for him, but it is still a huge plot twist when you're playing through this story mode. At number 9, we have Atlas in BioShock, and in this game, you play as a man named Jack, who was flying in a plane that crash-landed in the Atlantic Ocean, resulting in him stumbling upon an underwater city called Rapture, where things, well, they're clearly not right. You end up communicating with someone simply known as Atlas, who helps you along your journey and helps keep you alive by telling you how to harvest the little sisters and defeat the big daddies, as well as kill various other characters and enemies throughout the game. But things get very, very weird when it's revealed that Jack has been brainwashed the entire time and he was following orders from Atlas following the trigger phrase, "Would you kindly?" This completely shifts the entire story as you start thinking back to all the things that you killed and all of the evil things that you've done just because Atlas asked you politely to do them. This was a huge shocker. At number 8, we have Dr. Hayden in Doom 2016. Throughout the excellent reboot of the classic FPS series, you are led along your journey by Dr. Samuel Hayden, a mechanical scientist stationed at the Mars base that was attacked by demons. He helps you find the evil Olivia Pierce, as well as talks to you throughout the thing, where he upgrades your weapons, your armor, everything, in order to make things easier for you. He's a bit of a strange character, and he always seems to be on the verge of snapping, but you never really expect a full betrayal from him due to how helpful he is. However, at the very end of the game, literally the very end of the game, right after you kill the final boss, it is revealed that Hayden was only helping you so he could use your strength to retrieve artifacts and materials that he needed in order to continue his work. And the game ends with a cliffhanger of him locking your armor down and sending you in to a dream state. And you know we're going to be getting another Doom sometime in the future. One of the best interactive drama video games of all time is Heavy Rain. And at number 7, we're going to talk about Scott Shelby. Now, in Heavy Rain, you play as various characters who are all connected in one way or another to the Origami Killer, an unidentified murderer who has been slipping through the grasp of the authorities for years. You really get to know the characters as they go through various extreme hardships, like having to cut off their own fingers, all kinds of cool stuff. However, no one saw it coming, but it was revealed that one of the main characters was actually the Origami Killer all along. When it's revealed that the detective Scott Shelby really is the killer, it turns the entire story upside down as you think back to all the times that you actually helped him find evidence and you helped him get closer to finding the killer, when in fact, in reality, he was doing all that to cover up his crimes and make you believe that he was on your side. You actually helped him kill people and you didn't even know it. At number 6, and if we're being honest, this is probably one that we should have seen coming, yet it still managed to take everybody by surprise. Citra in Far Cry 3. You play as a young man trapped on a strange island trying to save his kidnapped friends from pirates and make it out in one piece. And throughout the story, you're somewhat helped along by Citra, the sister of the main antagonist, Voss, because she happens to be in love with you. Now, there are two possible endings to Far Cry 3, each of them involving Citra in one way or another. You have the choice. You can either save your friends and leave the island or abandon your friends instead to live your life with Citra. Now, if you choose to save your fridge, which most of us probably did the first time we played the game, she actually ends up sacrificing herself for you out of love. However, if you choose to stay with Citra and let your friends die, you two, well, get it on and she'll turn on you and kill you as soon as it's over. So while you kind of deserve this fate for letting your friends die, it's still a pretty massive surprise when she plunges the knife through your chest immediately after you guys are done doing the deed. I guess at least you got to go out on top, kind of? I don't know. Cracking into the top five today, we have 343 Guilty Spark in Halo 3. I don't like this guy at all. It's kind of a strange situation. When this little robot is introduced in Combat Evolve, it's clearly a villain. He has villain intent on activating the Halo rings and wiping out all sentient life in the galaxy so it can kill the Flood. But when it's reintroduced in Halo 3, it serves as an ally along your journey to kill the Prophet of Truth, also take out the Brutes, and once again, defeat the Flood. Guilty Spark actually serves to be very helpful throughout your journey, helping you identify weak points in enemies and lead you to victory. However, at the very end of the game, our little buddy suddenly has a change of heart when he realizes the character's objectives conflict with his own, leading it to killing Johnson and becoming the final boss of the game. Now, some of you may have seen this one coming due to how sketchy of a character Spark is throughout the original Halo trilogy, but for many of us, this betrayal took us seriously off guard, especially when Spark actually killed Johnson. At number four, we have Wheatley in Portal 2. Speaking of robots betraying you, this is one of the best puzzle games ever made, released back in 2011, and a robot betrays you. You play as Shell, who starts the single-player campaign by waking up in a stasis chamber and being guided through her escape by a very nice AI named Wheatley. After accidentally waking up the iconic GLaDOS, you end up stumbling upon a way to give Wheatley an insane amount of power, which automatically corrupts him and turns him against you, turning him into the game's antagonist. You are then forced to make your way through maze after maze, solve puzzle after puzzle, in order to put an end to Wheatley's rage. Now, Wheatley is actually one of the few video game villains I can think of. Well, it feels bad for his betrayal, I guess you could say, as Portal 2 ends up with him floating through space after his defeat, and he talks to himself about how he actually regrets allowing himself to become so overtaken by the power. But too little, too late, my friend. At number three, we have Cortana. That's right, Halo 5 Guardians. Despite this campaign being pretty bad, it contained a very surprising plot twist involving one of the most iconic characters in gaming history. In case you don't follow the Halo universe, which you should, Cortana died in Halo 4 after sacrificing herself for Chief's survival and to avoid her decline into rampancy. However, she reappears in Halo 5 in a very, very weird way. After coming face-to-face with Cortana once again for what should have been an awesome reunion, it is revealed that Cortana actually is planning to execute a mass forced disarmament of the entire galaxy in an attempt for galactic peace. Chief sees right through the plan and tries to tell her that it will cause more destruction than she realizes, but Cortana's stubborn, and she responds to this by locking him up, solidifying her as the new villain of the Halo universe. Now, the Halo community wasn't happy with the decision to bring Cortana back as a villain, but regardless of how you feel about the plot point, you cannot tell me that you saw this one coming, and it makes it eligible for this list for just that reason. At number two, we have Joel in The Last of Us. Now, this is a pretty tough one, and I don't think anyone wanted this game to have the ending that it did. The Last of Us tells the story of Joel, a man who ends up dedicating his life to defending Ellie, a young girl during an outbreak of a deadly virus that turns humans into zombie-like creatures. Near the end of the story, it is revealed that Ellie's body has the capability to create a vaccine for the virus, but her life would have to be sacrificed for it. Now, Joel decides at the very last minute that he doesn't want Ellie to die, and he ends up murdering everyone in the hospital preparing for her operation while Ellie is unconscious and then escaping with her. You may be thinking, well, it's because he cares for her and doesn't want her to die. So why is this a betrayal, Jimmy? Well, the betrayal comes when Ellie wakes up and asks Joel what happened while she was unconscious. And finally, the number one spot today can go to no other antagonist in video games than General Shepard in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. You probably saw this one coming, and Call of Duty fans refer to Shepard's betrayal as one of the biggest plot twists ever, and we still, to this day, harbor a deep hatred for this guy. Throughout the game, you fight with various squads under the command of both Price and Shepard in order to get closer to Makarov, the game's main antagonist. At one point, you're informed that you have narrowed Makarov's location down to one of two places. You have to go investigate the first spot. After getting injured on the mission, you make it back to the evacuation site where Shepard meets you, waiting for the intel that you bring. Unfortunately, after you give it to him, yes, he kills you and your surviving squad mates, including the fan favorite character, Ghost. As Shepard stands over you while your body's burned in the field, you hear the chaos that is this betrayal caused on your comms, and it adds to the insane weight of this entire event. Now, Shepard's betrayal still angers COD players everywhere to this day, but thankfully, we got to jam a knife right through his eyeball at the end of the campaign, preventing him from repeating the process to someone else. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 shocking video game betrayals. Let me know some that should have made this list. There's a playlist below if you guys want to check out all the other video game top 10s. And I just want to say thank you to everybody that watches these every day. I'll see you tomorrow for a new one.